boys. That's not fully automatic, you're a pussy.
All right, we got Exodus playing on the insurgent side now, and we have the Redcoats rocking the U.S. side. And we don't see any splitting of the forces on Exodus this time. They all seem to be going south.
Yep, absolutely.
Well, they got one up there. Sick Pup is heading up north. I don't know if he's trying to do a throw him off type of thing.
Yeah, he's gonna. Looks like he's gonna head up there. Just give him a little bit of contact.
Totosaurus went down in the south.
Think.
Yep, bees are starting to move in. Yeah, I guess Sick Pup is probably just doing a little bit of recon for them, seeing how many they send up there.
Yeah, probably throw them off, thinking that they've got more forces in the area than they have. Just a little bit of a diversion.
You know, I'm thinking about it right now. I'm wondering whether we should actually sit on the... It might change the tickets right now, but we're sitting on the Exodus side, and they only have one squad, so there's no commander comms to even listen to.
Right.
I mean, we can. Now we won't be interrupting anybody else talking, but... Yeah, I just noticed that they don't have two squads, so we're not going to hear any commander's comms on this side.
Do you want to risk the tickets?
No, I say we stay put. I don't want
to
risk the tickets.
You'll be able to pick up the local chat as well.
Yeah, the only thing with that one though, Oaks, is that myself and Blitza won't know when Rusty gets down in there to hear it. We don't know that he's down there getting it unless we follow his camera around.
If they're talking a lot, I'll just say comms.
Raj.
Sweet.
Snapper going down there. So it looks like we've got, it's a little more split now. Sick Pup and Kazo and those guys are now on the north side.
Yeah, they have split it up.
But yeah, no, they are definitely focusing towards the southern objectives. And the Redcoats are kind of going pretty far on that northern flank, north of Market. Rusty K out there.
Yeah, Sick Pup seems to be on his own, kind of testing what they're doing up there, if you see him. Oh, that was almost a great rocket into the Market.
Yeah, so it looks like Exodus are taking up pretty much the same tactics as previous, with just holding the first two flags, if possible. Although Redcoats have got that north marketplace locked down currently.
Yeah, Exodus definitely concentrating most of their forces in the south. We've only got two of them up in the north. And the entire Exodus crew seems to be up at the moment.
You can see the Redcoats taking those three flags, Public Well, Gas Station, and Brickworks, the U.S. Army. Market is still up for grabs.
Yeah, as Blitza noted, it looks like, Exodus is not trying to play that, let's go get the other flags behind them. They're just sitting on those two flags closest to them.
If it was me personally leading this Exodus force, I'd probably say mix up the tactics. It didn't work last time round, so let's try and play it a little bit different. Throw the Redcoats off a little bit with some new tactics. But let's see how it goes. It's not over yet.
Nope. We're at 141 on this side. That Jim Jam has had a lot of team kills. Like misplaced nade.
Okay.
in your boy.
Fuck's sake, I'm so sorry.
Yeah,
mate.
I'm not releasing, otherwise it's 3 tickets.
Fucking noobs.
How's the tickets looking, Oaks?
Awesome, mate.
144 for the Redcoats.
We're at 141, so you know.
The room you can cap from the outside, Jim. I got 3 in there.
Very cautious again at the start from both teams here. Taking it slow. Not too much action going on. Just getting a foothold on the map first, and then progressing from there.
Where was he, Jim? Where was he?
Yeah, we still got a couple up in the southern. There's southern flag. They're definitely fighting down there for it.
Someone naded.
Looking like Exodus have got this.
At Brickworks.
Yeah.
Two guys on the roofs about to spot each other here in a minute. Yep, there he went, and there he went, going falling down the roof.
Going falling off the roof.
That was pretty good.
Glad I caught that.
So if I could just get this brickworks, it's gonna be a nasty dint in the Redcoat tickets. Be interesting to see how the game goes from that point.
Absolutely. Yeah, so it looks like it's just Kazo and One Sick Pop just really testing the waters to the north, but the Redcoats are starting to get pretty close to their police station defend flag.
Well, Exodus, I have to imagine right now, is probably neutralizing Brickworks.
I'm guessing.
Quite a few of them there.
Yeah, I think that's gonna be pretty important for them. I can see Rossi in the rear actually.
So Hickman came in and took down Matt. So it looks like Exodus guarantee at Brickworks knows that they're there now.
Oh, Rossi just got a lovely grenade in there.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah,
oh,
that.
There's another grenade on the outside. Got Hickman down.
Yeah, absolutely. Wow.
There's bees on the wall here as well, getting a couple of kills.
Yeah, these Exodus guys are going down. Looks like the Colonel's the only one up. NCK, just Colonel.
Totosaurus Rex have got 5 kills, 1 death right now. Wow, Bees is at 8 kills, 2 deaths.
Wow.
Yeah, that's Bees.
That guy's a machine, man.
Oh, he's ruthless.
So we've got a lot more action converging on this eastern side. Looks like the Reds are definitely pushing in on those flags right up near Maine.
Yeah, absolutely. If that ground is open, they're going to take it.
Well, and I wonder if the Exodus guys don't really understand that that's what's about to happen because, you know, they're just leaving. So if Creeper and... these guys don't open up, which they just started doing.
Yeah, they've got to pin them down in some way to slow their
advance.
Well,
one of them's down up here on the roof, so the only one up here up still looks like Creeper.
Kazo with the SVD.
We've actually got Dipsauce moving in there, who's the medic.
Yep.
So if Crix holds on, yeah, he's going for him.
Well, he's got support coming in too, Russ moving in, but Marcazo's watching it up there on the other rooftop, so watch that medic might go down in a minute.
Yeah, I'm watching Sick Pup, he's kind of just lobbing some RPGs in the general direction of the Redcoats. I think that they're at least trying to pin them down, keep them from advancing so quickly while their forces take Brickworks.
Yeah, Pup just took down the medic there, so they're stuck for the minute. He's pretty tasty with that RPG. Once it Pup, he gets the kills with it, definitely.
Pup.
Yeah, Exodus have got a real foothold on this south side, though. If they can push north from this point, they're going to have full exposure on those two flags.
Brickworks now neutralized. The EUK is kind of getting excited about it.
Where the fuck is this not capping?
I don't think that they know that the Reds are largely going on the, that eastern flag area on police station.
You know, that's really where they could benefit by having one sick pup, even in just another squad. And so you can separate out those commander comms so that they know anything coming on squad comms is coming from one sick pup. And they're not really communicating that right now about what forces are over there, but they are taking brickworks. So we'll see where that goes.
Boy, Bats, if Bats is the lat guy, he just well placed, took out two guys.
I think Bats is playing AR.
Then it was CKY then. Yeah, they're making the assault on the on Brickworks.
Absolutely.
Hey, occasionally give us, I see you're over Brickworks right now, Rusty, but if you ever move over to a different cat flag, let us know so that then we can go over and try to make sure that we're watching the same things and can speak to it other than, you know, the audience hearing me talk about something that's going on in a different portion of the map, you know?
Okay, I'm going to zoom over to police station where Redcoats have neutralized it, which is going to be a big play.
Yeah, looks like Exodus pushing them out, though. Starting to sweep the area.
We're at 117 tickets for Exodus UK.
125 here for the Redcoats.
Copy.
125.
So, you can see now, and this is what happens quite often in a game, this flag's neutralized. You see all of Exodus flock to it now to make sure they get it back in their possession to you know, not lose those tickets.
Right, absolutely. You can see him really pouring into the compound now. Go back. So much smoke everywhere.
Yeah, Russ is up on that second story still trying to see anybody. I think he's the only one. No, Crixus is still up.
He's coming behind him. There's one coming behind him.
Oh, yeah, here he goes.
Ah, he gets him. Gets
Russ got
another
him on
one
that
coming.
One. Yep.
Russell there, them steps.
Oh. Russ gets off the roof. Oh, and he goes down.
Oh, he went down, though.
Wow.
You should have heard his local comms there. Oh, my God.
Oh, I'm sure it's typical Russ.
Okay, so this is the issue you've got now. Redcoats have taken that flag of Brickworks and they're moving to rooftop now. If they've got a full cap there. No resistance to get that. Sorry.
Whoa, football field, sniper.
Jim jamming one sick pup, calling out contacts in the football field. EUK guys are moving that direction. Got Creeper, Dip, and Crixus, and Rusty K over there. Looks like they got a rally over there. So that's where they're coming from. On that northwestern side. Zooming over to Rossi and these guys. Redcoats over here by Brickworks. Actually, it's rooftop garden. Rooftop house. These guys are sitting at right now. Neutralizing that flag. You know, it'd be interesting to see EUK say, okay, we're going to lose rooftop house, so let's shift our momentum to the right side of the map and go for market from here.
Yeah, that would be the logical choice based on their positioning currently. I mean, well, I can tell you now, when that rooftop gets neutralized, they're going to push it. Just because of that ticket loss, they can't risk it. There you go, watch your move now, neutralized. That's if they can get away from Russ, who's doing a good job of keeping them pinned there.
Gonna pull up top here and give a overhead view what's going on. So yeah, most of those redcoats sitting over there by rooftop house. Exodus now almost within the police station area entirely. You can see Rex there up north though, or out through the west rather.
Yeah, they pulled down rooftop house.
Yeah, they're gonna move pretty strong on police station from there too, I'm guessing. Interesting to see how Exodus moves.
I can't tell. It looks like they're just going to sit on rooftop. They're just kind of covering down on it. I don't know if they're going to employ that tactic they used last time where they just let him come. What tickets you had, Oaks? Oakley.
Here the redcoats start to move into the police compound. Oh, and they take it by force. Moving quickly in.
Hey, Oaks, you still around, man? You got the tickets?
Yep, we're at 118 here for the redcoats.
Okay.
We're 80 here for UK.
So the Redcoats moved into that police station, but Exodus made a push on Marketplace.
Right.
Yep. We might end up with one of those scenarios of two neutralized flags.
Yep.
It looks like they're coming back, though. Colonel and Dark Angel pulling out of Market.
Well, it's a risky decision.
Yeah, absolutely. I don't think they've found that Redcoat rally.
Squad League work the games. So, interesting to see how they go now.
Alright, get me up to speed, fellas.
So we had a redcoat push onto the police station, which was just before you left. They got wiped completely. Had to run back in from main. So Rossi's squad are sitting on rooftop, and Russ is staying in the marketplace area.
Okay.
So we just made a point of saying, you know, that's a lot of tickets wasted on that police station, so they're looking like they're going to sit back now and just let them keep that police station rather than waste those tickets.
Just to give you guys a little bit of insight, the Redcoats are talking to each other here. They're saying they're about to make a coordinated push on the point in 10 seconds.
Okay.
You can see Bats coming around the rear first.
Yeah, he'll be getting set up and letting the lads know if there's anyone coming in from main. Here they go, they're pushing.
Smokes go in.
Oh, RPG'd.
Yeah, it goes down.
Looks like he killed himself to get that ticket.
Yeah, he did. Yeah, I'm looking forward to that next map update on this one. If you see it, you know how much more this is going to get flushed out. This is going to be, I think this map, slowly but surely, people will start enjoying a lot more.
Oh, yeah. A lot of people find that when this map comes up with Insurgency, it becomes a really bad shitstorm, and it's just all over the place, people going into main bases, and it's not a favorite. I think, like you said, when it opens up and you get more area, it's going to be a completely different game.
I think so too. And speaking of insurgency, we kind of, you know, we've talked about ourselves, like, when, you know, when do you host an insurgency map or round? But I think we need to wait until the proper logistics are in before you do insurgency, because, I mean, me personally, seeing freaking all these tire walls and all that stuff, it just, I don't know, it just doesn't look authentic right now at the moment, you know what I mean?
No. Put it this way, I never play insurgency, so...
No, I think it has potential to be a great map. For competition-wise, I think 5 and caches is way too many. I think probably 3 would be okay for competition. Almost the skirmish version of Insurgency, you know?
Yeah, in its current form, it's not good viewing, I think.
I agree. I don't think so either yet. Yet. It doesn't mean it won't become better.
Of course.
But AAS is just that standard, tried and true, you know what I mean? Like, just old trusty.
Yep. Okay, so Reds have got a foothold now in the police station with reinforcements coming in. See if Exodus can do anything about that. But no doubt Matt and Jim Jammer get some casualties in there.
And the insurgent forces neutralize the market.
Yep, they're trying to get up there and take that. I wonder if the Reds are going to pull back to that point or just say, have at it, you know?
Right.
I didn't even see that. The issue they've got, they will not be able to cut police station while that's neutralized or in Exodus's possession.
Right.
Yep, they'll have to split.
We'll have those.
Oaks, what ticket you at?
We're at 99.
All right, we're 57.
Yep.
Oh, I didn't even see that push from Exodus. So that was great work across the north.
Creeper will be the first one for the Redcoats to go ahead and run back to market. Just throwing grenades in there.
You know, next match will be interesting. We're going to be covering OP First Light for the first time.
Yeah, absolutely.
Right back.
It'll be fun.
Love that map.
Yeah.
A creeper got taken down there on his little push. A waste of a ticket, but at least he knows they're in there, no?
Looks like the Redcoats are moving towards that general direction. Russ is coming back. CKY is coming up from the west. UK has taken that point, so now they have the police station and market. Rossi and his crew still pushing on the police station, but now pushing from rooftop house as EUK, Jim Jam, and Colonel move on their left flank. Colonel goes down. Starting to get pretty thick over in the market.
Yeah, Redcoats have managed to push back in and get a foothold. Just Chronic still up. So if they can take him and take the flag, that's going to be another pinch on the Exodus tickets, which it's going to hurt at this point of the game.
Absolutely, already sitting at 51.
It's really reflecting now the importance. If you make a push for that flag, you better make sure you keep it. You know, you lose it within the time scale we're looking at here for Exodus. It's going to hurt. We can't afford that in these type of games.
Right, absolutely.
Doing a good job of holding that police station currently, though. Definitely repelling everything Rossi throws at them.
Yeah, they're moving. Looks like they're moving from that police station and kind of using that as a base to attack from the market instead of going around the right side, which is pretty unprotected. But the Redcoats kind of still sitting in the trees over there by rooftop house.
Yeah, and you can see here on this police station, there's only really one way in through the two gates.
Right.
So taking it is a real task.
You see there, Redcoats now neutralizing market.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to we've got coming up, Blitza, you know pretty well about this, but anyone out there in the audience sphere. So our first match in February, we've decided we're going to do four clans versus four clans. Each clan's going to bring 9 people, and they'll have 8 in a squad, and then we're going to give them 1 cam. So each team will play a normal round with everybody. But then we're also going to have a video contest for the month of February to see who can come up with the best 1-minute, essentially, clan commercial using both first-person footage and a cam who's solely tasked to follow his squad around, recording their cams and getting some good aerial footage. So they'll have the entire month of February to create that 1-minute video. So I know a lot of the clans behind the scenes that have that are looking forward to signing up. That's going to be a pretty cool one. It'll be quite different. And then we can use those commercials as match introductions to show who's facing off and who, or, you know, halftime intermissions we can play to showcase some of the other clans out there. So I think that'll be a good one to watch for the beginning of February.
Absolutely.
Yeah, as you said, multiple clans have already got big grins on their faces, coming up with ideas and where they're going to do it. So I'm looking forward to seeing all the entries. It's going to be... going to be some show.
It will. And what I like is it puts creativity in your guys' hands for things that we get to use for all of us. You know, we get to use it as introductions for your matches, and it hypes your own people up. You know, I think it'll be good theater.
Definitely. You can see Exodus have got a good line now pushing to the west. Got a nice spread across the map, so maybe they can get some foot in here.
We've got 20 tickets now for Exodus. Oakley, how's our tickets looking for the Redcoats?
72 here for the Redcoats.
72.
A better round than last round, but Redcoats is a clear victory, unless Exodus can kind of stop a ticket bleed of kills themselves, of deaths themselves, not ticket bleed.
Yeah.
Ticket bleed.
Yeah. No, Exodus will learn from that first round. You know, these are top players, and they've adapted to it, and it reflects in the score. It's nowhere near as far and away as the first one was, which was a shock, certainly to me. And I know that Exodus, I know Chronic very well, the leader, and they're taking their time recruiting boys in. They're picking the people who suit them, and I'm looking forward to them getting the 18 boys out on the field. They're gonna kill it.
Yeah, I think that's being a clan. I would assume sometimes it's tough because you want to get so many people in to start playing 18v18s or 24s and 30s. You know, but I think you want to get those guys that just suit who you are. You know what I mean? Versus just let's just bring in anybody we can.
Of course, and Chronic is no rush at all. You know, the guys who came into squad originally with him, very tight knit. They've been together years. And it's, like you said, picking the right people, and I'm sure they will. They've already got a few new boys in that very much suit the way they play. So, looking forward to it.
Yeah, I assume it's got to be tough, too, to be a clan and turn people down that want to play with you, you know what I mean? Because sometimes it's not always a right fit. And, you know, some of these clans, they have an age limit, you know, and you don't want young guys in there because of, you know, just what they might be exposed to within the clan, you know what I mean? So it's, I'm sure it's tough managing some of that stuff.
Definitely, and like you said, you know, with this exposure that the clans are getting now through Squad League, you know, a lot of people are coming into the game, brand new to the game, and they're instantly sending out messages wanting to join because these clans are the ones that people want to be in through this exposure. So you've got to juggle that as well with, you know, the people that you play with that might not suit the game, and then these people who are faceless essentially, and they just want to get involved.
Yeah, I always thought that the best path to figuring it out is joining a server, not just talking about yourself in a forum post, but joining a server, trying to play side by side, proving your mettle there, and getting to know the squad leads and the other players from those clans and saying, yeah, that's not quite my style, or man, this is, I'm gelling with these guys, hopefully that works out. You know, I mean, to me, the playing is where you find out who should be in a clan or not.
Definitely, 100% agree there. And it works the other way as well. The clans, they'll only you know, recognize the people they've got the in-time game with, and they're the only people they'll consider for recruitment. You know, they'll go, this guy's solid, you know, let's get him in, or the other way around.
Yeah, without a doubt.
Are we
so
doing
six tickets?
Yeah, are we doing an after party after this, or are we going to wait until the...
No, what my thinking on this one is, because we need to get Age of Kill and SFSS in here as fast as we can and get it sorted, we need to get all these guys out, we need to get those guys in, get the map changed. I say we do one large after party with just the squad leads after the next match.
Okay, sounds good.
That's if your boys are still up, Danny.
Oh, I'm sure they will be. No doubt about it. They'll be buzzing.
All right. Well, then, you know, after this, you go hang out with your boys. We're going to bring in Doc East to support the next match. And then, you know, when that match wraps up, you guys get back in our team speak. And then, you know, we'll bring you guys down as that transpires.
Cool. I'll relay that once this is complete.
Yep. Get that message out to Chronic, too, if you can.
I'll
see. Just because we're going to be dealing with a whole other set of stuff.
Yeah, don't worry, I got it. Nearly over here with the two tickets, Oakley. How you looking?
They're at 70 tickets right now.
We're at 2.
Yep. So good match from both teams here. One thing I really love about these clans is that they look at these matches, whether they win or lose, and they say, you know, how can we do better? And that's the attitude you have to have, because you learn so much about how your clan plays and how you play individually as well from having these matches. So coming back from either a win or a loss, there's always something to be learned from, and that's what makes these guys so damn good at their jobs, is that they're always like, you know, how can we do better? So
yeah, well, without a doubt.
Well, that's going to do it for us for Exodus versus the Redcoats. We're going to take a break and get Age of Kill and SFSS into our server, and we will be back shortly and have more matches in the afternoon soon. So we'll
next
see
one on
then.
OP First Light.
Yep, OP First Light coming up in not too distant future. We'll see you guys soon.